Than Talent Radio.
More Heart Than Talent Radio is brought to you today by my audio training, 7 Steps to 7 Figures. Do you frequently ask yourself, how do I questions? Do you feel stuck at a financial plateau? Do you suffer from entrepreneurial seizure? Would you like to learn the steps to reach 7 figures? The impact of mastering the daily disciplines of a 7-figure income earner can assist you to change your finances, improve your relationships, improve your self-esteem, and so much more. But only if you know the steps to take to get there. If you are committed to creating 7 figures in the next 12 to 24 months, you can receive your copy of my 7 Steps to 7 Figures audio program for 50% off today. Go to goldenmastermind.com/7 to receive your audio download instantly.
The vacuum law of prosperity. What does that mean? It means making room to receive, opening space in your consciousness, opening space in your communication style to create and or attract your reality, people and situations that will foster your meaning, your cause, and your purpose. That is what tonight's call is going to cover. So it's very important that you understand what prosperity is. Prosperity is not necessarily money. Prosperity comes from a Latin term, prospero. It means to flow or in the flow. And in the flow, if you're in the flow, you will be in the hands-free zone. However, if you find yourself in resistance, or you are the force or you're a counterforce to someone else's negativity or someone else's control, and you keep finding yourself creating the same situation over and over, then you want to step out of resistance and move into the hands-free zone, move into conscious awareness, or move into the flow. It's also imperative that you start to have clarity. You have mind sight, not only eyesight, but you have mind sight. You can see the outcome before it happens. That means being able to find the horizon line, the vanishing point, the spot way out ahead of you where you know you're going to be while you look right down at your feet, because this is where you are here and where you are now. As you be comfortable, as you get comfortable with who you are and what you're becoming, and as you separate your feelings from the past and start to be and stay present, then you won't overwhelm yourself. But if you chronically overwhelm yourself, worry about situations that haven't happened, then you have no space to allow. Being able to allow is to allow new situations to come to you, allow new people to meet you, to allow yourself to let go of the control that keeps you in control of being out of control, and allow prosperity to show up on your doorstep. And in allow is a permission state. But if your esteem, your self-esteem, is really based on self-confidence, meaning there's a distinction between the two, you can be competent and confident about a vocation, about a trade, about your knowledge or your insight, but if you're not comfortable with self, then you will rely on self-confidence, where your ego requires a reward, recognition, love from other people, and other situations that will keep you perpetuating the same set of feelings over and over, creating the same result. But as you begin to separate your feelings from the events that shape them, then you are you and you are free. So in esteem, and esteem, self-esteem, as you begin to create your own esteem, you are not dependent upon recognition, rewards. You're not dependent on someone else's love. You're not dependent on anyone else's approval. You are you, and you are free. Now, self-esteem is independent, is not dependent. And in that independent state of consciousness called awareness, as you start to enhance your esteem, then when you receive recognition, when you receive rewards, when you receive money or you receive love, then it enhances your esteem. But if your esteem, which becomes self-confidence, is dependent upon a reward recognition or someone else telling you, attaboy, attagirl, then you become dependent. And as you move into being independent, independent of others and independent rather than codependent, and you're not over-obligating yourself, overwhelming yourself, then you can be self-sufficient with self-esteem in free enterprise where you can create and attract what the free market will bear. Now, this is not to be confused that you are selfish, but when you are self-reliant, then you are self-inspired. You don't require someone else to tell you what to do because you are you and you are free. You're in command of your emotions. And as you let go of the anxieties that keep you perpetuating the same set of feelings, then you will begin to release the people, the situations, the thoughts, and the stories that no longer serve you. You will also begin to release clutter as you start to create this space called allow. Allow is a new vacuum. It's a new vacuole. It's a space in your consciousness that you begin to clear up. When you hold on to other people, other situations, when you continue to let your family members put you in a position you have to validate, justify, and explain yourself, when you continue to let family members walk into your house without knocking on the door, without ringing the doorbell, and they have full autonomy to walk right in and violate you, put you in a position you have to validate, justify, and explain yourself, then your body's going to give off a corresponding response called anxiety. And as you begin to live in that anxiety that you created over and over, creating a very high tolerance to this anxiety, you have now become the mind-body connection to the events that have shaped your feelings. And as you live in an overwhelmed state, you're living in clutter, chaos, you'll attract your reality the same type of dysfunctional relationships that keep you addicted to a set of feelings. Now, when you really start to wake up, you start to understand, you move into the allow state, you move into a state of consciousness called awareness, then you can separate your feelings from events. That's what letting go means. When you hold on to events or when you hold on to what you don't know, that's what many people do, is they don't know. They live in a I don't know consciousness. I don't know what happened to me. I don't know how this happened to me. I don't know how to let go. And I end sentences by saying I don't know. People that live in I don't know live in doubt, because doubt is a very safe place to stay disappointed. And in that state of disappointment, you don't achieve the appointments that you are seeking. So this is what many people do, is they set themselves up to disappoint themselves by making goals bigger than their actions, by having goals bigger than their commitments. And if you're not commitment conscious, then you will be commitment phobic. And then if you're commitment phobic, your communication style will foster a set of feelings that has a communication style that says kinda, sorta, like to, I guess, and I don't know. When you do know, when you know, when you K-N-O-W, when you know and you know that you know, then you will not be denied. This is what changes your energy. Your energy is changed by your consciousness. Your consciousness is your awareness. But when you continue to live in a, I don't understand this, I don't know why this happens to me, I have a good intention and a poor delivery, I intended to make my bed but the day got away from me, so I'll just get in the bed that I didn't make today and perpetuate the same state of overwhelmed clutter, chaos, and drama that I live in. When you live in dysfunction, not functional, dis meaning not, when you're in not functional relationships, you're not functional in your body, your immune system, lymphatic system, adrenal system usually are off. Your cervical spine, your lumbar spine, and your thoracic spine usually subluxates itself because of the events you hold on to. And when you say that you're nervous, when you say you worry all the time, what that really means is you're in a state of feelings called anxiety. And that is anxiety what leads to feelings of being in control, of out of control, which keeps you in a state called addictions. As you begin to have a better understanding of why you do what you do, you're creating space, and that space is called allow. As you allow others to compliment, you actually hear the compliments. When someone lets you know what a good effort you're doing, you don't deflect it, you're able to receive it. And to be able to be in the here, in the now, in the present, it's important that you let go of the events that shaped your feelings. It's not a how do I, it's an I am state. When you have clarity, when you are clear about who you are, what you're capable of, and where you're going in life, then there's a centrifugal force that starts to create an undertow. And it's that undertow that creates the power. Power and self-esteem are synonymous because they are like gravity. They do not require any outside centrifugal force to move them, because they self-esteem isn't something that has to move from here to there. Self-esteem is now. Self-esteem is its own power. It does not require an outside power. It does not require conflict. It does not require force. It's not right or wrong. It's not black and white. It's not the dichotomy of do or don't. Self-esteem is. And as you are, I am, as you live in that state of consciousness called the present, now, awareness, then your energy has shifted. You've stepped out of doubt and you moved into awareness. And that awareness gives you the consciousness that you require to understand. Now, as you understand, now you can integrate. Now you can apply. Now there's application. You're able to be creative. You don't ask yourself, how do I get leads? How do I? You move out of an I do state, how do I? You move out of a how do I state into an I am state. When I am free, when I am me, when I am lovable, when I am capable, when I am the leader that people are looking for, then people begin to feel me. That kind of energy uplifts. And when you're in any kind of anxiety, that energy detracts. That energy is closed down. When you're in self-esteem, that energy is a allow state. That state of consciousness when you're allowing people to connect with you, allowing people to show up with you. When you're in a allow state, there is no pressure. There is no control because you understand there's nothing to control and pressure is an illusion. In that state, you're able to adapt and adjust quickly. So instead of worrying about the airplane taxing or worrying about being late, you know you're going to make it on time. You're not going to make it at the very last minute because you no longer live in this frantic state called anxiety. As you let go of the control that keeps you in control of being out of control, then you can be you and you are free. And in that freedom that you create, that's an allow state. You're allowing yourself to be your best. Rather than trying, tomorrow was really yesterday, to be the best, you take the pressure off yourself that never was there. You have a better understanding of how you had to perform to a set of standards that you could never meet. As you begin to understand who violated you, who criticized you, who put you in a position that you were never good enough, as you no longer hold other people's feelings responsible for your feelings, as you no longer hold other people in a state of anger and feel like you've been violated, traumatized, taken advantage of, when you let go of being right so that you can be rich, then you have moved into a higher state of awareness called consciousness. And in that consciousness, now you can begin to uplift, raise other people with you. You don't take anyone with you. People follow you because of your energy. You don't get people. You're not a getter. Your objective is not to get people to go to an event. You don't get them to perform. That's not what you do. That's not what you do and who you are. As a man and woman of influence and affluence, you lead by example. And your energy has become so powerful that it begins to uplift people. In your awareness, they join you because of the energy that you are transmuting. And in that type of energy, that is now energy. That type of energy is charisma. That kind of energy is a high set of standards that can be met because they're the standards that you create are the standards that you live in. And those standards are your standards. You don't place those standards on anyone else. You are accountable. You don't hold yourself accountable because there's nothing to hold, because accountability is like gravity. It's self-esteem. You're accountable for your own esteem, not for anyone else's. And in your own ability to love yourself, you're not loving yourself from a selfishness. You're loving yourself from power, the power that uplifts other people. And in that energy, people feel you, then they join you. This explains the phenomenon of they show up. People show up not because you show up. People show up because you have less anxiety, less worry. You're not as overwhelmed. You're not putting pressure on them or you. You're not trying to be someone you're not. You're relaxed in your body and you're being who you're capable of being. And you have short-term, clearly defined goals. You live in a place called clarity. You can see the outcome before it happens. You start to enhance your extrasensory perception, your sixth sense. You start to be intuitive because you now know. And you stop putting pressure on yourself to get to a destination that you're so overwhelmed you can't get to, that you sabotage yourself before you start. That was a lot right there. What many people do is they put so much. They put a lot of pressure on themselves to be in a place that they're not really committed to being. It's somewhere called out there. I'm not sure if I can put myself out there, but I'm going to go out there. And they tend to set goals so big that they can't start. And you want to be able to set clearly defined short-term goals with the daily method that you operate in a place called clarity, where you have a very clear vision of the outcome that you are committed to creating. As you let go of the events from your past, you will begin to attract your reality, people and situations that foster your meaning. When you have meaning, purpose and cause, then you are cause-driven. You are purpose-driven. And if you walk around the planet going, I don't know my purpose. Well, your purpose doesn't have to be some philanthropic goal to change the universe, but your purpose is your purpose. Be clear on what your purpose is. Be purpose-driven. It can be something as simple as being able to pay your house off in a five-year period. I walked a woman today through a precise method to be able to liquidate her debt so she can live in a place called the present. She's able to have a clearly defined plan and an outcome of what is required of her to be able to free herself from the debt. And as you be, I mean, that's a purpose. And then when you free yourself from that debt, now that's other monies that you can allocate to other asset preservation, to other asset creation, to other endeavors, joy money, travel money, philanthropy money, money that comes from your self-employment in a place called free enterprise. As you have self-esteem, you can now employ yourself. You can't employ yourself when you have no self-esteem because you're not good enough. You wouldn't hire you. When you are good enough, now you can hire you to be your best employee. You be the president and CEO of your own corporation. But if you're a chronic avoider, chronic procrastinator, you wouldn't hire you, and you won't be able to attract your reality, a top-tier producer, a top-tier employee, a personal assistant, because you won't have the respect that you require from people in your circle of influence. When you lead by example and you are the example, then you become the mind-body connection to a new set of awareness that you are creating. When you're a bad example, when you don't make your bed, when you're overwhelmed, when you're worried all the time, your energy is very low. Your transmutational energy operates from a place called apathy, one of the lowest places you could actually send a signal in a place called a mixed message. It's virtually like walking up to someone and saying, please join me in a business, but I'm not comfortable with myself, so let's go ahead and get this over. Why don't you reject me? I'll move on, shut down, and avoid being a business owner the rest of the day. Unfortunately, that's a metaphor for a lot of people go about their daily activities. There's a difference between activity and action because action is paramount. Action creates results. Action blazes a trail. Activity creates dust. Activity moves around in a circle. Action is gravity. Action is results. When you are relaxed in your body, you will attract your reality, people and situations that will foster your cause, purpose, and meaning. When you're overwhelmed and anxious, worried about outcomes that haven't happened, you'll attract your reality, people and situations that will be connected to the corresponding response that your anxiety creates. Emotions and anxiety create a corresponding response. When you live in a repressed state of anxiety, overwhelmed, not understanding why you do what you do, you continue to attract the same type of people that violated you in high school, the same relationships you had as teenagers and in your 20s, because you become neurochemically and emotionally addicted to a set of feelings called anxiety. And that anxiety of anger, hate, resentment, guilt, shame, abandonment, rejection, overwhelmed feelings, grief, and apathy, then you are transmuting your energy in a very low vacuum of anxiety. But as you gain clarity on what you are committed to attracting, as you release your unresolved anger, as you start to organize yourself and let go of clutter, as you release the dysfunctional relationships and you be honest with yourself and you no longer talk yourself into going to your relatives that violate you, you no longer allow other people to take advantage of you, you let go of over-obligating yourself, you become clear on what's important to you, you have a set of standards that's about you and a few people in your circle of influence, you stop trying to over-obligate yourself and help and rescue people, and you devote your energy to learning the skills, habits, and mindset, then you start to devote your energy to creating a culture, you start to develop a mastermind alliance of like-minded entrepreneurs that you can collaborate with in free enterprise to create goodwill, results, and solutions. And when you live in that space, that's creating a new place to allow. You allow yourself to love yourself. You're allowing yourself to let go. You're allowing yourself to be human. You're allowing yourself to be lovable. You can receive a compliment, accept a compliment. You can give a compliment and receive one back because now there's a win-win situation. You're no longer in a win-lose situation. You don't focus on winning. You focus on being your best. Instead of the rewards that you seek, focus on being your best. Develop the skills, because it's the skills that allow you to win the rewards. So what many people do is they're so reward conscious, they don't create any profit. They're so consumed by winning the next trip, winning the next lottery, winning the next reward, getting this, getting that, that they don't focus on learning the skill set because they're so addicted to the rewards that they're not relaxed in the present to be able to create the results. And, I mean, results are great, rewards are great, but you also want to be prosperity consciousness. You want to be able to create goodwill. You want to be an ambassador of your vocation. You want to be able to buy into the process. And you are you and you are free. You start to create a one with type of situation where there's no separation between you and the outcome. Because in this type of results consciousness, there's not a winner and there's not a loser. You're not trying to win a reward. You're creating goodwill. You're delivering service and value, and you're also in free enterprising, creating commerce for yourself, your teammates, and others, because you are bringing to the table benefits, products, features, services, and you're also selling the dream. And when you come from that place of energy, that is called power. And that type of power does not succumb to any force, because power does not have conflict. Force has to have a winner and a loser, has to have conflict. It has to have a counterforce. Someone has to be wrong. It's a right-wrong dichotomy that many people live in, and they go out of their way to prove other people wrong. It's amazing how I watched someone attempt to do that with me today, how they try to put me in a position that I had to validate, justify, and explain myself. But in a relatively quick series of questions, I was able to neutralize that situation, move out of the conversation, and move on. My objective was not to prove anyone wrong. My objective was to disengage from this conversation, because it was a very adversarial situation that had no connection, no prosperity, and no reward. And as you step out of anxiety and stop trying to force yourself and force others into complying with your wishes, as you begin to let go and allow, you'll be amazed at what begins to show up. When it's showtime, it's also show up time. That means when the bell rings, you're listening to it. It's in your inner ear, and you're actually up before the bell rings. You're already dressed. You're in your house of pleasure, and you're producing results. But if you perceive what you're doing to be painful, then you will avoid the outcome that you are manifesting in your head that you think is going to happen, because you're so anxious about failing. As you let go of failing and focusing on learning the skills, then you can practice the repetition and experience that will eventually create the 10,000-hour habit. And as you begin to live in the hands-free zone, as you change who and what you attract, now you're living in a place called prosperity consciousness, in the flow, the hands-free zone. This becomes a way of life. It becomes an identity. It becomes you, and you are you, and you are free. You're no longer in anxiety. When I ask you, what are you doing to get overwhelmed? Your answer is very simple. You state, I don't get overwhelmed. Now, many people are going to attempt to talk you into getting overwhelmed. They're going to go, sure you do. Everybody gets overwhelmed. You're going to say, not me, baby. I don't want to be overwhelmed. I'm in the hands-free zone. I don't require conflict. I don't require input from you unless I seek it. Many people will give you their 2 cents worth. They'll give you your advice. Stop receiving or accepting advice from the people who don't have what you don't want. These are the people who are the flaw finders of the world. They want to tell you why what you're doing will not get a result. They want to talk you out of your dreams. They don't really want you to accomplish your dreams. They want you to struggle like them. How dare you step out of their struggle? When you are no longer the mind-body connection to the events, when you are you and you are free, when you can let go easily and effortlessly, when you're not addicted to an outcome that has not happened, when you are not reward and recognition conscious, and you are prosperity conscious, then you're in the flow versus the resistance. When you are in a place called esteem, you're not dependent on anyone else but self, because you are self-reliant in self-esteem. Now, I understand we deserve love, we require love, we require recognition and rewards, but you earn it in a very, very grassroots type of situation organically. You receive the rewards because you're not attached to the outcome. You create the rewards because you create the results. And you don't do it in an overwhelmed panic state. You do it in a very relaxed body. Now, as you learn to live in a relaxed body, you'll be you and you will be free. You won't be so attached to the outcomes that you're overwhelmed. You won't disappoint yourself and avoid success because you're failure conscious. You'll be able to relax into your consciousness and create on command. Now, being able to create on command is a very innovative, creative state of awareness where you're able to focus on a result. You set clearly defined short-term goals. You have clarity in your purpose and your vision, and you track your reality frequently. People of like mind, i.e. people who believe what you believe. When you're in anxiety, overwhelmed, undisciplined, unorganized, don't have any direction and don't know where you're going, you'll tend to end up in someone else's dream, a place called a job, where you're self-directed with self-confidence rather than being in free enterprise, with self-esteem being free, being self-reliant. And as you move into that state of awareness, then you are you and you are free.
Thank you for listening to More Heart Than Talent Radio. If you enjoyed today's content and are committed to creating seven figures in the next 12 to 24 months, you can receive a copy of my 7 Steps to 7 Figures audio program for 50% off today. Let me ask you this. Do you frequently ask yourself, how do I questions? Do you feel stuck at a financial plateau? Do you suffer from entrepreneurial seizure? Would you like to learn the steps to reach seven figures? The impact of mastering the daily disciplines of a seven-figure income earner can assist you to change your finances, improve your relationships, improve your self-esteem, and so much more. But only if you know the steps to take to get there. To receive your audio download instantly of my audio program, 7 Steps to 7 Figures, go to goldenmastermind.com/7 to receive the training now. Receive the